Space medicine is a thing. And no, we're not talking about medicines made of compounds discovered on Mars, at least not yet. We're talking about the drugs you would need to survive in space. And it's a little more than an Advil, I can tell you that much. Turns out, getting to and living in space does some pretty crazy stuff to your body. Astronauts on the International Space Station live and work for months at a time in a microgravity environment, which is sometimes called zero gravity. But the term zero gravity is actually a misnomer because Earth's gravity is still acting on the ISS. But doesn't that mean that the space station is being pulled back towards Earth? Yep. Astronauts float because the spacecraft, and everything on it, is technically in free fall. The ISS is orbiting the Earth at a speed that perfectly matches the Earth's curvature, so it's constantly falling towards Earth, but will never hit it. And I thought roller coasters were terrifying. So microgravity is great for all kinds of scientific purposes, but your body would need some help handling it. If the blast off into space doesn't give you nausea or vomiting, it's really likely that your first entry into microgravity will. Our bodies have a specialized way of keeping our balance with our vestibular system, a series of canals in our inner ear. In microgravity, our way of navigating through the physical world, of sensing up or down, is totally thrown off and may cause us to feel nauseous. So astronauts may take anti-nausea drugs to get used to the environment. While motion sickness is so common in space that it has its own name, space motion sickness, we see similar issues out on the open sea. Ben LeCompte and the crew aboard the Seeker vessel are on an expedition to gather data to raise awareness about ocean health. As he swims across the Pacific, he and his crew aboard have already experienced motion sickness. Another challenge Ben and astronauts share? Bone density loss. His body's weightlessness in the ocean is surprisingly similar to the microgravity environment aboard the ISS. See, when we move our bodies back here on Earth, on dry land, gravity is constantly pulling on us. This makes our muscles and bones stronger, even when we're not explicitly exercising. But in space, our muscles and bones quickly become weak and start to deteriorate because there's little resistance for us to work against. One way astronauts on extended space flights combat this is on a special treadmill. They have to exercise an average of 2.5 hours a day, 6 days a week to keep themselves healthy. But a long-term stay in space could still lead to a loss of 1.5% bone mass per month. And it takes years back on Earth for your body to get back to normal. In addition to exercising and taking calcium and vitamin D supplements, astronauts also take a medication called Bisphosphonate once a week to prevent bone loss. But let's get a little freakier than just baseline health maintenance. In addition to your regular antibiotics and decongestants and antidiarrheals, astronauts may also use drugs that improve their cognition. On the ISS, astronauts have to complete extremely long and difficult tasks. To help them stay alert, they may take a drug called Modafinil. It's actually not a stimulant in the way coffee or even cocaine is. It's actually a class of non-addictive psychostimulants called a eudorheic, a wakefulness enhancer. It's used here on Earth to treat narcolepsy patients and for patients like astronauts, works to enhance attention, executive function, and learning while they stay awake for long periods of time. I really could have used some of that in college. Last but not least, space crews also carry tranquilizers. Space can be pretty freaky, and if a member of the crew were to lose it a little bit, their fellow ISS inhabitants would need to make sure they weren't going to do any harm to themselves, the other astronauts, or the space station itself. If someone were to go a little Space Odyssey 2001 on the ISS, their companions are encouraged to bind their wrists and ankles with duct tape and administer a tranquilizer. So that's fun. For more space stories, make sure you subscribe to Seeker. And to see how Ben's swim through the Pacific compares to the extreme environment in space, watch this latest episode here. This expedition will help us learn more about our largest ocean's marine life and the human body at the same time. Pretty cool. Thanks for watching.